Hello guys, so the method which I'm going to show you right now can be used to update the stable ROM to developer version ROM. Like if you want to install developer version ROM on any of the Xiaomi phones and you are currently on a stable ROM, then you can use this method. Or else if you want to come back from developer version to the stable version, then you can use this method. And if you want to revert back to older version, like on Redmi 1S, if you update your phone to version 50 and if you feel that version 47 was better, then you can use this method so that you can come back on version 47 and you won't be getting any force closes or anything like that. And this is the most safe and the most recommended method to use. And in this video, we'll update the Redmi 2 to the developer version, and you should download respective version of the ROM which you need to install. Like if you need to install developer version on the Redmi 2, then you need to download the developer version. Or else if you want to install the stable version, then you need to download the stable version. And to download the stable ROM, it is named as global on the download section. Like if you want to download the stable ROM for Redmi 2, then it will be named as Redmi 2 global. Or for some devices, it directly includes India, so you can download that ROM and you can start flashing. And after you download the ROM, simply put it into your internal storage, like put it in the internal storage of the phone, not in your internal storage. After that, go into File Explorer app and then go into phone. And now select the file which you want to install. Like this is the file which I want to install. So long press on that, select more and select rename. And now rename it to update. And guys, while renaming the ROM, make sure that U of the update is not in capital so that you won't face any problems after you go into recovery mode. And after that's done, go into home once again and now go into updater app. Hit the options button over here on the top right corner. If you are on MIUI version 5 or lower, or rather only on MIUI version 5, then you can press the options button over here. Select this, then go to reboot to recovery mode. Select this reboot to recovery mode and hit reboot now. And now we will reboot into the recovery mode of the phone. And as you can see, we have successfully booted into the recovery mode. Let me just reduce this. Okay, so now you can use volume up and volume down buttons to navigate up and down, and hit the power button to select. Like if I want to select English, then hit the volume down button twice, and when we are on English, hit the power button. So as you can see, we are here. And after that, select wipe and reset, select wipe cache and select yes, wipe cache. So this will wipe the cache partition. And now select wipe and reset once again, select wipe user data and select yes. This will wipe the user data and your internal storage will not be wiped, so do not worry about the internal storage. And after that, select install update.zip to system and now hit the power button once again. Select yes. So guys, as you can see over here, the update is getting installed, but while it's getting installed, it's like going to 1%, then going to 14, going to 3%. So if this happens, do not worry, it's quite normal as you can see. And if you have lots of apps installed, then the wipe data may take a longer time, so do not worry, let it take place by itself. And as you can see, update is completed. After that, simply hit power button to go back, select reboot and hit the power button and select reboot to system over here. So guys, after we boot into the ROM, you will see that if you open Play Store, then it will not open, it will just open and close, it will just open and close again. If you open some other Google app, then it will say get Google Play services, and if you hit get Google Play services, then it will just come back here once again because the Play Store is not working. So to fix this issue, download the APK of Google installer from the link given in the description below. Download that and simply install that. After you open the application, anything which is not installed, select that as install, and it will say that Google something in Chinese, I don't know what's that, requires Google service framework to work. And after that, simply hit OK. And now it will come to this page. And now simply hit this button over here. As you can see, simply hit this option and select continue. and use Zune blah 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 accelerator, select OK, and now it will download all the applications one by one. And as the application is downloaded, you can simply hit the install button and install that application. I will suggest you guys to stay on this application only, let it take a longer time, but stay on this application so that no application is skipped. Like the notification for the application to install comes, and if you just skip it, then you might get into trouble or you might have to install all the apps once again. So to avoid that, simply stay on this application. And as my Wi-Fi is very slow, it will take me a very long time, so I'll just skip the video, and after I have installed all the applications, I'll come back. And guys, as you can see over here, after a long time, I have installed all the applications, and as you can see, everything over here shows as installed. If we open Hangouts, it will be unfortunately closed. So in this case, what you have to do is simply select Hangouts, uninstall it, and now you can install it from the Play Store. And if you are getting post closes on the Play Store too, to fix that, go into settings, then go into applications, then go into installed apps, and here if you go into download section, you will be able to see Google Play Store over here. Simply uninstall this application, like uninstall normally. As you can see, I am uninstalling Google Play. And after that is uninstalled, go into Google Installer once again. As you can see, Google Installer is not installed, so it will show an option to install. Select install, and now it will download that file and install once again. If you get force closes on any other application, let's select YouTube, and we are getting force closes and on that too. So uninstall YouTube, and now you can install that through Play Store, as the Play Store will be installed shortly. I'll just install Play Store and I'll show you guys that you can download applications from here too. And guys, as you can see, I installed Play Store through the Google installer once again, and YouTube was giving some errors or it was not opening, so I uninstalled that application. And after that, simply select install and select accept and select proceed, and now YouTube application will be downloaded. So guys, as you can see, everything is installed and everything, like all the Google Play services are working. Like if I go into Play Store and I can download anything, and Google Play services is getting downloaded right now. So you can download everything from the Play Store now, and there is no worry. And the reason why I use developer version is because it has all the latest feature developed by MIUI, and it is updated on weekly basis, so there are no bugs. So that's why I like developer version, and I'll stay on the developer version on the Redmi 2, which I'm going to use now. So this is it for this video guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to hit the like button if you like this video, or if this video helped you in any way. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. And if you have any doubts or suggestions or any queries, then do let me know about them in the comment section below. So thank you guys. Thank you for watching.